Welcome back to my YouTube film review channel. And I've had another email from my regular correspondent, Id Idworth, who says, "Dear Pete, in terms of subscribers, your channel is putting up some pretty underwhelming numbers. But it could be that at some stage you will reach a tipping point and explode into global viral success. Or alternatively, your subscriber levels will just plateau and stagnate like your Twitter following." Oh, thank you, Id. You had to go there, didn't you? Perry Henzel's visceral 1972 Jamaican crime drama, The Harder They Come, is now on re-release.
I could make a record.
This crunchily powerful film exists between the two moods of its two most famous tracks, the aspirational lesson of "you can get it if you really want" and the downfall premonition of the title song. The desperado here really wants it, really gets it, comes hard and falls hard. It's a movie with Arthur Penn's Bonnie and Clyde in its DNA, and also Sergio Corbucci's spaghetti western Django, which in one scene is shown getting a rowdy screening in a Kingston cinema. Singer Jimmy Cliff plays Ivanhoe. The comparison with Sir Walter Scott probably ends there, although the name is a reminder of the British colonial hangover. He's a gawky country boy who comes to the Jamaican capital, Kingston, yearning to be a famous recording star. Swaggeringly laid-back Ivan, as he's called, gets a job in a repair shop on land owned by the local church, and he soon takes a shine to Elsa, played by Janet Bartley, the demure young orphan parishioner being kept, or rather groomed, as a virginal ward by the hectoring, controlling preacher, played by Basil Keane, who is creepily planning to marry her. Ivan and Elsa start their secret affair as Ivan begins his twin careers in music and crime, only to be strangled in both by monopolistic capitalism. He records a catchy single, "The Harder They Come," for a local recording studio boss who forces him to accept a flat buyout fee of $20 and blocks him from selling his single directly to radio stations and clubs. While his pop stardom fails to materialise, Ivan gets into the ganja distribution business in a small way, retailing pre-rolled spliffs, only to find that the colossally lucrative wholesale US export action is sewn up by top mobster Jose, played by Carl Bradshaw. The reggae soundtrack throbs and crunches and shudders in concert with the raw energy of Henzel's storytelling and Cliff's performance, but this doesn't preclude a shrewdly sophisticated and self-aware debate about representation. Ivan may not be an existential hero, but he knows he is going to die in the very near future, and this conviction accelerates his celebrity and his fanatical devotion to the swiftly dwindling moment of defiance. His fall is indeed hard. Like the cowboys he watches on screen, Ivan has a blood-in-the-sand reckoning with fate. That's it. Please give this YouTube channel a like and a share on social media, and very importantly, subscribe. And leave a comment to say that you've subscribed and what your star sign is. And also, buy my book, The Films That Made Me, an edited selection of my essays and reviews for The Guardian. I'm away on holiday now, but please tune in a couple of weeks.